Episode number 221. You see, said Lord de Winter, presenting that Agnante is sister, a young gentleman who has held my life in his hands, and was not abused his advantage, although we have been twice enemies, although it was I who insulted him, and although I am an Englishman. Thank him, then, madam, if you have any affection for me. Milady frowned slightly, a scarcely visible cloud passed over brow, and so peculiar a smile appeared upon her lips that the young man, who saw and observed this triple shade, almost shuddered at it. The brother did not perceive this. He had turned round to play with Milady's favorite monkey, which had pulled him by the doublet. You are welcome, monsieur, said Milady, in a voice whose singular sweetness contrasted with the symptoms of ill humor which D'Artagnan had just remarked. You have today acquired eternal rights to my gratitude. The Englishman then turned round and described the combat without omitting a single detail. Milady listened with the greatest attention, and yet it was easily to be perceived, whatever effort she made to conceal her impressions, that this recital was not agreeable to her. The blood rose to her head, and the little foot worked with impatience beneath her robe. Lord de Winter perceived nothing of this. When he had finished, he went to a table upon which was a salver with Spanish wine and glasses. He filled two glasses, and by a sign invited D'Artagnan to drink. D'Artagnan knew it was considered disobliging by an Englishman to refuse to pledge him. He therefore drew near to the table and took the second glass. He did not, however, lose sight of Milady, and in a mirror he perceived the change that came over her face. Now that she believed herself to be no longer observed, a sentiment resembling ferocity animated her countenance. She bit her handkerchief with a beautiful teeth. That pretty little soubrette whom D'Artagnan had already observed then came in. She spoke some words to Lord de Winter in English, who thereupon requested D'Artagnan's permission to retire, excusing himself on account of the urgency of the business that had called him away, and charging his sister to obtain his pardon. D'Artagnan exchanged a shake of the hand with Lord de Winter, and then returned to Milady. Her countenance, with surprising mobility, had recovered its gracious expression, but some little red spots on her handkerchief indicated that she had bitten her lips till the blood came. Those lips were magnificent. They might be said to be of coral. The conversation took a cheerful turn. Milady appeared to have entirely recovered. She told D'Artagnan that Lord de Winter was a brother-in-law, and not a brother. She had married a younger brother of the family, who had left her a widow with one child. This child was the only heir to Lord de Winter, if Lord de Winter did not marry. All this showed D'Artagnan that there was a veil, which concealed something, but he could not yet see under this veil. In addition to this, after half hour's conversation D'Artagnan was convinced that Milady was his compatriot. She spoke French with an elegance and a purity that left no doubt on that head. D'Artagnan was profuse in gallant speeches and protestations of devotion. To all the simple things which escaped a Gascon, Milady replied with a smile of kindness. The hour came for him to retire. D'Artagnan took leave of Milady and left the saloon the happiest of men.